This bone cleaver from Danja was a very pleasant surprise. Figure out why in this video. Hello guys, I'm Chef Panko and I used to work in a Japanese restaurant. Make sure to subscribe to know more about cooking and knives. Before we start with the review, I want to go over some disclosures. The Danja bone cleaver was gifted to me by Danja. However, Danja is not paying me to make this video or to include their knife in a video. No one will get a chance to preview my footage or thoughts before the video goes up on YouTube. If this video helps you decide, please give this video a thumbs up since that will help the channel a lot. Now with the disclosures away, let's start with the review of the Danja bone cleaver. The bone cleaver from Danja comes with a debossed logo on both sides of the blade. The knife also has unique striped hammered patterns and a blacksmith finish to prevent corrosion. The handle is a full tang handle made from wood. The 5CR13 from Danja sits between 55 to 57 on the Rockwell scale. It is an excellent hardness for bone cleavers. It adds extra durability and greatly reduces the knife's stress fractures while giving the knife decent edge retention. The knife is sharpened at a 45 to 50 degree angle per side. This angle drastically increases the knife's edge durability. There will be less bending and chipping while you cleave through thick bones. Danja's choice for a high angle of 45 to 50 degrees is to accommodate the bone cleaver for home use. To cleave through thick bones, you need a knife with a hefty weight, and the Danja with a weight of 700 grams has it. They managed to make the cleaver compact but still heavy due to a very thick spine of 5.4 millimeters. The spine can also be used as a hammer to break very thick bones for your bone broth. For the optimal grip, you grip the knife at the handle, and the balance point will be front heavy. The handle grip provides enough grip and generates enough force to go through thick bones. Danja also thought about the blade profile. The front area has an aggressive curve that prevents the tip from digging into your cutting board. It also keeps the front area sharp since there is no impact. The knife handle is nice and thick for comfort and grip, even when you reverse the blade to use the spine like a hammer. The Danja bone cleaver has my recommendation. It has everything I expect from a bone cleaver for home use. It is compact, heavy, and very durable. However, you must know that this is a dedicated cleaver to chop through thick bones or to cut through thick skin. It is not suitable for vegetables since it will split and tear the fibers. To maximize the usage and minimize any damage, you also need a dedicated thick cutting board. While this bone cleaver is sturdy, you should never use it to cleave through frozen bones. That's it for this video. If you have any questions or other opinions, leave them in the comment section below. If I help you decide, please give this video a thumbs up since that will help the channel a lot. If you want to know more about cooking and knives, please subscribe and hit the bell to get notified. Thank you for watching and I see you in the next video.